It's 7:05 p.m., May 7th, 2019. What do you do when you recognize dead people inside of people that are walking around living, or supposed to be alive? What do you do when you can recognize a person that has died because the person that has died is inside the body of people that are walking around, because you recognize their characteristics? What do you do when that starts happening? Huh? It's like five people right now I know have my deceased relatives in them because of the same characteristics that are unmistakable. What do you do when your stored treasures in heaven, where moth and whatever can't consume and destroy, when they use this technology and steal your blessed life? What do you do? What do you do, people, when this happens? What do you do when you're around three people with the same name as one of your relatives, and you know that their name is that because they are doing a recovery? Because these Rakshasas or these man-eaters have sit there and ate your family. And then these tall grays, which are the resurrected Egyptian deities, mutated because of their not being exposed to radiation. And so therefore they don't have the same look. They're gonna have this ugly look. What do you do when these Satanists conjure lamb? The little creature they call lamb. That's what was his name? Aleister Crowley. This simulation has to end. That's why I'm going to always be unhappy here, because I am surrounded by the twice dead, the walking dead, and the people that have eaten my ancestors or have outsourced their soul and injected them into other people's bodies. I am one of a kind, original. They can never replace me. They can never brainwash me. They can never make me think they can't never get away with it. And the cosmos needs to expand. They are trying to prevent the great expansion. They cannot lock me down into religion, because religion is man-made. It came from man. It did not come, I don't know how to explain it. If you are tied up with the cosmos celestially, like I've been shown, I want the USDOD sued or destroyed. If you're tied up cosmically and celestially with the cosmos, you're not going to look at anything as a religious thing. You're going to be like, look, my bodies and star bodies or whatever is being messed with, and I'm in excruciating pain. All right? You're going to be like, forget religion. You can forget religion, but you do not forget spirituality, because spirituality is the unseen, it's the invisible. It's what your naked eye can't see. And I'm not about to be tied up in this anymore. The great expansion has to happen. Whatever kind of experiment this is, it needs to end. Because my blessed life and heavenly stored treasures were stolen. There's nothing wrong with being a human being and enjoying your human life. But you need to respect boundaries and you need to respect body space and mind space. And that was not done because someone has an infatuation with my image. And tried to brainwash me into playing the Babylon whore and the Scarlet Woman. And trying to build a case that I'm licentious, that I'm immoral, that I'm abortionist, that I'm all this stuff and I'm not. All because of envy and jealousy. Of finding out the origin and finding out the truth and deciding to run a psyops to destroy it. I do feel like I'm going to become a massive killer now. And they know it. That's why they had to chop me up in all kind of little and outsource my energies, because they know that it's going to be instant debt to those that have done this and tried to curse me into a human form. Huh? Tried to curse me into a human form. Tried to take away my Vedic knowledge. Tried to brainwash me so I don't understand the Vedic truths. All the truths that I'm propounding to you people. It's not being given to me through no artificial intelligence. This is being the original speck and dot of the cosmos to know this stuff. Ron P. Angel, the US DOD and NCIS puppet needs to be apprehended, needs to be arrested. He's not your holy grail. He's not your genius. He's not your historian. And this charade on Union Landing Road needs to be undone. I'm not looking at none of this as real. My Yar Vardan knows that. And he needs to step up. Since they ran a software that he was going to be the pedo. Huh? Why did y'all do this to the back of my neck? Huh? Why did you do this to my coccyx? You better start talking, Russ Warwick, James Ranks, Ron P. Angel, Stefan A. Schulman, Wally Urab, Dana Horachowski, and yes, I'm going to keep repeating those names. William Mount. And who else? I said Russ Warwick already. Stefan A. Schulman. It's another name though. I said James Ranks. And I'm sure James Casbolt's gonna say something too. In India, you need to come forward about what y'all have done. Because the great expansion's going to happen. Anyway, whether any of us like it or not. USDOD Naval Intelligence. Are we all spiraling into a black hole? And if so, that would be my coloratry. Y'all gonna spiral right into me and be gone in the great expansion, because I've had enough of your Jasons and your dictators and breaching the multiverse and done some serious damage. I'm never going to look at this life as something that I can prosper in, because you intended for me never to prosper. I see that, and that's why I got to end everything, because I will never prosper as long as I got haters and envious people who can't accept what I am.